nearby the beaches of Daytona, the Falcons are soaring on a four-match win streak and building momentum for another postseason run. Today, they welcome Thomas University on a special Soccer Wednesday coming up next. And welcome, everybody, Daytona State Soccer Stadium. It is a windy Wednesday here at the complex as Thomas University JV has come to town to take on your Falcons. I'm Drew Felios alongside Ted Sofianos. We are ready for what should be an outstanding match. Daytona State getting the better of Thomas University the last time these two teams played by a final count of 10-3. But Ted, this is one of those matches. If you're Daytona State, you don't want to take it lightly.
Correct. I mean, you don't want to get one of the things that DSC has going for it, obviously, is a 10-3 win, as you just mentioned. But at the same time, you don't want to get too overzealous with that type of win. You want to stay calm. You want to keep on purpose, keep on point. And by the way, DSC right now ranked 8th in the NJCAA polls as of today. That was the new figures that came out this morning.
Falcons, of course, in the familiar blue on the left, and the Nighthawks set of Thomas University on the right, wearing the white and the green today. Both teams on the field for our national anthem. We will pause and wait for that. As the Falcons come in ranked right now number 8 in the NJCAA poll. 42 goals on the season. And today going to be hungry for war. So just about ready to go here in Daytona Beach for Daytona State. Several players shining today in blue and gray, but one in particular, the goalkeeper, Phil D'Amico, sophomore out of Orlando's East River High School. He is pacing things right now in the net.
Yeah, and unfortunately what happened last time with a red card and a one-game suspension, it just got a little heated. The referee kind of saw the last reflex of a little bit of a skirmish, and unfortunately Phil got caught and ended up with the red card instead of that one-game suspension.
Yeah, that red card coming against ASA Miami, so Phil very excited to be back on the pitch for Daytona State. And on the other side, Brandon Krambeck, sophomore keeper out of Tallahassee, the Florida State University School. He is going to be under fire here today because right now the Falcons offense really clicking.
They're really clicking. And as you look at a 10-3 loss, for Thomas University the last time they played, this keeper is going to be under fire all day long. And I know that Brad certainly going to keep the pressure on Coach Brad Sasnett. I'm sorry, Bart Sasnett.
So Daytona State, very successful against Thomas University. Talked about the 10-3 victory earlier this season. That was back on September 6th. Also able to take down the Nighthawks JV program two times last season in 2016 and the inaugural year. The pitch is absolutely perfect here today. This field pristine, the brand new Daytona State Soccer Stadium. You know, every program that comes here, they know when they walk into this place, it is really something special.
And Drew, how lucky are we to be up here in the brand new press box and overseeing? You know, it's like the gods smiling upon us because the sun has just come out. Obviously, the wind is going to play a factor, though, today.
That certainly is. Ribbon cutting for this great venue going to be on October 10th. Talk more about that a little bit later. 120 by 80, the dimensions on this gorgeous surface. And Thomas University has come to play here today. Remember the NAIA Sun Conference. They've only got one win on the season, four losses, and three draws. The one victory coming over Weber International. That was a 3-1 victory earlier this season. Meanwhile, Daytona State, they've won their last four matches. And they've got a couple conference wins, both of those coming on the road. But, you know, when you're coming off a big win against Eastern Florida, they beat their rivals 2-1, and then October 1st took down ASA 3-2. Those are big momentum matches that Daytona State has on their resume this year.
Exactly. And right now, I think you're going to see a game of control. We're going to try to play it calmly. Bart has a European feel for the game, loves to have control. And Coach Bart, I mean, utmost respect for him. I mean, look at the record he's had amassed already in just a year and a half.
Coach Sasnett in his second season telling us earlier this week, this is my dream job in my dream city.
And the fans are starting to show. Even though it's a bit windy, maybe not the best conditions, and we're off to start.
Sit back, enjoy. Should be fun. From Daytona, Hunter Strickland with it here to start for Thomas University. The Nighthawks in their last match coming off a 3-3 tie. That was to the University of Mobile on the road. Quadri Glass able to touch number 56. And Daytona State struggling to possess here in the opening minute. Alvarez, another touch for the Nighthawks. And tell you what, Thomas University playing pretty fast right now here in the opening minute.
Well, right now they're possessing the ball. They're doing some good things just from a kind of a key loss right in the middle. And there's a shot that went awry.
So Daytona State with D'Amico in the net. Also going to keep an eye on number 29, Craigton Charlton, freshman forward out of Jamaica, who has just been dazzling so far in 2017. Manny Perez, another player we're going to be talking a lot about for the Falcons, wearing number 7. He is a lightning bolt down there on the field.
Now, as you notice, the wind is blowing right now against a Daytona's offense, which, you know, they're going to have to play a game of control to
Here's O'Sullivan with a lot of open space to work with, chasing it down for the Falcons. Daytona State inside the 18 now, looking for the 1-2. It was cut off by the Nighthawks, and now Daytona State will reset it. Manny Perez able to get a touch, and the Falcons able to apply some early pressure here.
Yeah, they're looking good. They're looking good. And it's going to be a little bit more difficult to possess as you're into this raging wind. I think you see the second half be a little bit easier for DSC.
There's Kavoy Bailey getting a start. Another youngster from Jamaica, sophomore for the Falcons. Daytona State now working quickly once again. O'Sullivan pushed outside the 18, tried to get the cross in, and the first corner kick coming up for the home team.
Yeah, that was well done. Well done. Possessed the ball, beat a man, and tried to play it in and, you know, right off a defender and first corner for DSC.
So Marco Tomic, guy who was on the bench last year for the Falcons, has fought for his starting role, playing a key role for the Falcons. Gets a ball that was placed in a good area, just outside the 6 now. Shot was taken but deflected.
I was surprised he didn't take that first time.
Now Perez fighting against two defenders, and this is what Daytona State wants to do.
Yeah, right now they're possessing the ball. They got a lot of people up, but that's because the opposing team has collapsed, and they need to spread the field if they want to take it on to Daytona State's defense.
Ted, you've had a chance to watch this Falcons team this season. What do you think's been the most impressive thing about what they've been able to do so far this year?
what I love, they're playing basic fundamental soccer, good trapping skills, good dribbling skills. They certainly have from some of the talent that's already out there.
See the speed right now. There's the deflection and a goal right in front of the net. So the Falcons don't waste any time getting on the board. Joe O'Sullivan for the easy tap in.
O'Sullivan, I mean, he's been an engine for Daytona State's offense, and now the score was just, he was in the right place, right time off a deflection. Way to go, O'Sullivan. Good job.
So a goal in the fourth minute for Joe O'Sullivan, and that's his team leading now seventh goal of the season. Charlton set it up. O'Sullivan just kind of topped it off. He was in the perfect spot.
Yeah, the keep did his best to try to play it out, but it was a darn good shot, low and to his left. And again, he pushed it off, but O'Sullivan there.
Falcons should have the skill edge here today. And I think one versus one, the overall speed going to be really tough to handle. But here comes Thomas University now the other way, breaking loose and looking for the penalty inside the box. Let's see if we get a whistle. And the official there to step right in, and an early yellow card. Surprising.
Early yellow, but there was too much handling going on there. A little bit too much pushing. And it looks as though he's standing on the penalty spot.
So Thomas University going to get an opportunity now to tie this game.
You know, the referee didn't gesture right away, so I'm surprised.
So it's going to be Valencia, number 37, doing the honors. And we are equalized at one apiece.
Yeah, 1-1. It was obviously just a bad foul. You used too many hands there. You need to keep your hands to your sides and shoulder the man off. And unfortunately, he was pushing off with his hands, so I couldn't see from this vantage point whether or not the referee... You know, I always have an issue with some of those guys, you know, especially when they give the opposing team penalty kicks. But I know we'll bounce right back.
And look at the expression from D'Amico. He doesn't allow a lot of goals. That's only the sixth goal this season that the Falcons goalie has surrendered. So that does not happen often.
Yeah, he is the Iron Curtain for sure.
So what a start here in Daytona. Back-to-back goals within a minute. Here's Sandage handling on the far side. Now Charlton able to touch once again. Perez with lots of time and space on the near side, but it closes quickly as Arbeláez comes over to defend.
Yeah, great weak side ball just played. Excellent. Excellent job there. Spreading the field.
Tomic now handling along the touch line. Now it's Perez. Notice, of course, the wind here today as Bailey touches for Daytona State. Ted, how does the wind affect play here throughout the day?
Oh, you're dealing with just a 3-pound object, and that thing's going to get blown all over the place. And there's a ball well in.
That's a tremendous ball. Now Thomas trying to counter once again, showing some speed at that forward spot. And a good job by D'Amico to come over and deflect it in a corner kick coming up for the Nighthawks.
Yeah, D'Amico showing his skills there, playing it, cutting down the angle, getting down on the knees.
Jesper Svall applying the pressure for the Nighthawks. So both teams taking chances here in the opening minutes. You just get the sense that we're going to see a lot of goals here today.
Another great weak side ball, but the wind had a lot of effect on that.
Played once again, and the cross nicely in there, and the shot scores again. Right by D'Amico. And Thomas University making an early statement. It's 2-1.
Yeah, defense needs to get shored up. Looked like a handball, but Jiminy, I mean, that should not happen.
Jose again, Carlos Gonzalez, the guy who scored it.
And again, you know, I was talking a little bit about before, a loss for words, but, you know, you don't want to be overconfident just because you beat a team, 10-3 in the previous match.
Jose Carlos Gonzalez Avalanita, freshman out of Spain, giving Thomas University the early lead. So if Daytona State was perhaps taking the Nighthawks a little lightly, I guarantee you the Falcons, it's definitely gotten their attention here early.
Definitely a wake-up call, Drew. And I know that head coach Seznet is not happy at this moment.
Here's Ryan Sandage, center mid. Gets it over now to Perez. Daytona State will play a little bit faster now. Charlton needs to get involved. Nice 1-2 there. Perez chasing it down in the corner. Here's Sandage trying to get the cross in. That'll be another throw in for the Falcons.
Yeah, a bit of a wake-up call. Now they're applying pressure as they should be.
Keep in mind the Falcons winners of four in a row. This has definitely gotten their attention here early. Keep in mind with Thomas University and a JV squad, you can always take players from the varsity team, possibly move them down to be more competitive in a match like this. I guarantee you they are showing Daytona State a few things that they probably didn't see the last time these two teams met.
You know, you make a great point. We don't know if some of those same players that might have played varsity have now come down a little bit to perhaps give a tougher task to Daytona State's men's soccer team.
Quadri Glass, redshirt freshman out of Atlanta, sends it back to the keeper, Krambeck. Now Falcons trying to gain possession. Once again, they'll throw it in along the far side. If you're just tuning in, you've missed a flurry. Falcons scored early, got the goal by Joe O'Sullivan. Then Thomas University came right back. Goal by Samuel Valencia. And then one by Jose Carlos Gonzalez Avalanita.
Here's Perez again. Penalty.
Perez tried to get the cross in. Nobody home that time. It's also critical now, Ted, for the Falcons not to panic, to continue to play their game and not try and get that goal back and more goals back in one swoop.
No, you're 100% correct. They are applying the pressure as they should be. It was just a couple of costly errors, a little lackadaisic efforts there, and I think they've come alive now.
Nice pass back, and now Avalanita attacking once again. Arbeláez in the corner. 44 cut off. That's good defense. Donovan Segre wearing number 8, first team all conference a season ago for the Falcons. The defender is tremendously athletic and can certainly be a threat attacking.
One of our co-captains wearing the red band today.
Here's Manny Perez. Can tell Thomas University taking notice every time 7 is able to handle it on that right side.
Well, he's got some jets on him, doesn't he?
Asking our official that time for a hold, not going to get the call.
I sense a little frustration. They just need to keep playing their game, as we mentioned before, and put an equalizer in the net shortly, and they will gain their confidence back.
Falcons now playing up top the 18, trying to create a little bit of space. Ball was taken away at just the last moment that time. Send it back to D'Amico. What do you think is going through the mind right now, too, of Phil D'Amico coming into this match, only 5 goals given up the entire season. He's already surrendered 2 in the first 12 minutes here. Yeah,
two words, bit aggravated.
Tomic tries to send it downfield. Now trying to clear. It's Charlton. Charlton one-on-one. Trying to shake free. What a move that time. As the ball deflected, and it'll be another corner kick for the Falcons.
Beautiful dribbling skills. Beautiful dribbling skills. I mean, he had him out of his boots.
Saw D'Amico there on the other side, hoping his team can equalize here. So second corner kick for Daytona State. Goes short with it. Shot taken. It'll sail high this time. That ball kind of got caught in the wind.
Right. A smart play over there. It's a short corner. Certainly with the wind the way it is. Didn't want to do have a floater up there with just a bunch of heads knocking around. So short corner and then get it closer to the goal for the cross.
Miguel De Leon right there, number 19. 5 goals scored this season. Playing a little bit out of position for Daytona State, but it's the one good thing about this team. Players kind of playing not exactly their roles that they are most comfortable in, but they're making this thing work right now. And 19, De Leon, one of those guys.
Well, when you have a player that can wear 2 hots, I mean, that says volumes.
Here's O'Sullivan trying to turn. That ball is certainly live with the wind here this afternoon. It's kind of doing a lot of things you wouldn't expect. Sometimes players have kind of struggled to get control of it, would you say, Ted?
Yeah, but I got to say, this JV team is alive and well from what we experienced the last time they played DSC.
Have a whistle.
Here's the wind
on the field.
And some good sportsmanship shown by Thomas University's number 44.
Saw what the wind was doing on that last shot, as Manny Perez tended to by his teammate Ryan Sandage. So Perez, who represents most of the speed offensively for the Falcons.
And we just showed our respect for sportsmanship right on back. Played the ball out of bounds for them stopping the game.
Hunter Strickland throws it in for Thomas University. Here's Tomic. Perez handling now. Nice pass over to the corner. Let O'Sullivan do something with it. Here comes the cross. Header on point, but Krambeck climbs the ladder to pull it down.
Well done. Excellent job. At the same time, you saw how that wind just knocked the ball down. That was going upper corner. In Greek, we say Rama in the upper corner.
Headed top shelf.
Exactly.
Thomas right now playing with lots of confidence. Tomic able to get it back for the home team. Daytona State, 8-1 so far in this young season.
You know, although it's not a conference game, we certainly want to see them get, back on the horse. They just need an equalizer, and they're trying real hard right now. They've possessed in the Thomas University's end for quite some time now.
Here's a shot. That's a long one. Deflection is free, and the goal is there. The Falcons able to equalize. Second one off a rebound, and O'Sullivan is feasting right now in front of the net.
Oh, that's twice. And the keeper, again, did a good job, but that was an excellent shot down low to his left. So we know where the Achilles heel is for this Thomas University's goalie.
So a goal in the 4th minute, and now in the 15th for Joe O'Sullivan. And with 2 goals already in this match, he's now got 8 on the season. Watch Krambeck. Couldn't reel it in. I'll tell you what. If you're Krambeck, you've got to make that grab, or this Falcons lineup is going to make you pay.
Right. Yeah. They're going to eat you alive on those dispossessed balls and the ricochets.
D'Amico comes up to field this one. And for Phil D'Amico, sigh of relief at the moment as Daytona State is equalized at 2-2. So Drew Felios and Ted Sofianos, along with our fabulous crew here at the complex here at Daytona State.
And Drew, how are you enjoying our new digs up here in the press box?
I am blown away at the moment. Fabulous. First class all the way. Manny Perez. Nice touch that time. And O'Sullivan's going to be marked tightly throughout the rest of the match. He got a little nudge that time by a Nighthawk.
He's a stodgy kid, though. Stodgy kid. He's got that build. Stocky, stodgy. It's yep, either one.
Tomic tried to send it in. Are you reinventing words here in this first half? Here's another service. This one sails a little bit high. Now Perez can go chase it down.
Good effort. Good effort.
But the wind is still continuing to pick up. You see the referee's flags as he raises it. Our officials doing a good job adjusting here today. And I mentioned our referees here today. Nardi Abeshi is one, the lead official. Kirsten Schroeder is the other. And Tony Baumert is our third official. So this game well officiated so far through this first half. And we've seen a flurry of goals. 4 goals total up to this point. It's been a scoring fest.
Yeah, which makes me think that our defense is on both sides. We got to shore them up.
Sandage now for Daytona State. Sends it back out. Another service this time. Perez trying to deal with it. And it went out of bounds. It'll be a goal kick for Thomas University. So 2 goals by Joe O'Sullivan right now representing the scoring for Daytona State.
And I think they're finding their groove back after a bit of a slow start.
1 loss for the Falcons this year came to University of North Florida. That was back in the opener on August 13th. Seems like ages ago in a 2-1 victory. Then you had the hurricane that this team had to deal with, Ted. And then you had, of course, the loss of some players. Team captain, the center back, Roy O'Keefe, goes down. That was a huge blow to this team. They've had to overcome a bunch of adversity, haven't they, to get to this 8-1 mark.
No, that you've said it exactly the way it's happened. But again, with adversity, we have to show tenacity, perseverance, persistence, and that's what this team is doing right now to show the equalizer at 2-2.
Coach Sasnett raved earlier this week about his team's resilience, how they have just been able to hang together and play on. And those 2 big wins, one over Eastern Florida, the other over ASA, right now filling the confidence of these Falcons. Nighthawks now with a good possession here. Hunter Strickland gonna touch it here with lots of time and space to work with. He'll service this one in. No one home at the top of the 18. Right back is Arbeláez.
You know, I got a remark on the skill level of both teams. To play in this kind of wind and play a possession game is not very easy. And both teams are showing the fundamentals and a skill level that's not even a JV team. They're looking above that at this moment in time.
Valencia had a nice touch. The ball will roll out of bounds, and it'll be a throw-in for the Nighthawks. Yeah, hard to believe when you watch this Thomas University team play that they've only got 1 win on the season. I guarantee you some adjustments have obviously been made. So Nighthawks able to throw it in, trying to get this one in position. Here's Felix along the far side, trying to slow this game down just a bit.
Good dispossessed by the Falcons.
Also got to mention the head coaching situation for Thomas University as O'Sullivan tries to work again, this time against two defenders, fights one off. He's on the deck right now, and we may have to stop this match just for a moment as the officials will tend to him. I believe Hunter Strickland is the guy on the ground.
Yeah, I missed what happened exactly there as we were following the ball. Obviously, it was a clash with O'Sullivan.
Mentioning the head coach situation, though, Ricky Zambrano is not here. So right there in the black cap, that's Joey Lopez. He is the athletic assistant coach, but today acting as the head coach in Coach Zambrano's absence. So this team not only here in a tough place to play at Daytona State, but they don't have their normal head coach, and right now they're faring pretty well.
Yeah, I mean, of course, I'm sure they've had dealings with the secondary coach, but it's kind of like, you know, being with your stepfather rather than with your dad.
See some of the guys right there. Moore Lean, number 54, distributing water. Team effort right now for Thomas University is Hunter Strickland, helped off the field by the training staff here at Daytona State. So hopefully Strickland is okay. It's good to see him walking, although he does, of course, need some assistance there.
Exactly. Had some assistance, but looks like it might have been a sprain or just a bad kick to the shin. You know, they wear shin pads, but they don't always protect when you get into the, you know, two legs clashing. Especially with some speed to it.
So if you're Coach Lopez, you got to love what you were seeing here in the first half of play. We are just over 20 minutes in. Thomas University did go down a goal, 1-0, but came back with two of their own before Daytona State was able to equalize. 61 will come in as the new player. That's Harry Batley, the freshman out of England. Good international presence on the Nighthawks side here this afternoon. So the Falcons all tied at two. Daytona State working just outside the 18. Ball taken away right there. And now the Nighthawks try to settle things. Thomas University in the NAIA Sun Conference. Quadri Glass, the redshirt freshman from Atlanta. Falcons come up, play it out of there. Ryan Sandage, once again, the center mid, doing a good job here in this match. O'Sullivan, the hero so far. Perez looks like he is running full speed. He was shaken up a little bit earlier in the half, and now Sandage operating once again. I think right now the passing maybe needs to be a little bit more crisp and a little earlier for the Falcons, would you say, Ted?
Exactly. Right. They're kind of telegraphing right now, but lucky enough we have a foul called against Thomas University.
Sometimes I think critical to keep that ball moving, make that defense work.
You probably notice in the kind of the pregame, well, let's let this play develop.
Dylan Burke with the service. The ball sent up by number 24. That's Trevor Golikowski in the match right now for the Falcons.
And Drew, you might have noticed in the beginning, you know, the pregame, they were in their grids. They'd like to get into triangles, and that's what you try to do throughout the game is put it into triangles and have those crisp passes, those 1-2 balls, as you mentioned before. And they just kind of lacked that a little bit toward the middle of the first half.
De Leon. Good pass there. Trying to create a shot. It's taken, and it's just a little bit wide.
Oh, that was well done. Well played. Put a great fake on him. And almost at the bottom corner.
Miguel De Leon. This guy can take over a game quickly. 5 goals this year. He's an attacking mid who's playing outside. He can go left or right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, really super good player. And we'll see more from him in the coming minutes.
It's number 61, Harry Battley. Fresh legs in there for Thomas University, and now a throw-in coming up. Arbeláez, the freshman mid out of Orlando.
Well, it's impressive that they got back to equal, to even Steven. And a good call by the ref there.
So to go the Falcons' way, Perez active throughout the first half. Phil D'Amico will put this one in place. The sophomore goalkeeper for Daytona State, the transfer out of West Florida, who has just been fabulous in the net here today. Has not really had a chance to showcase those shot-stopping skills that we've been used to seeing all season. It's been kind of a sporadic game, and now the Falcons threatening. One-on-one, shaking and scoring. Another goal. This goes to Miguel De Leon, who beat the defense.
De Leon with an amazing fake. I mean, you think about how calm and collected he was as he beat the keeper. And then, of course, stuffed it in from the 6-yard box. Extremely impressive, extremely mature move and player there.
Miguel De Leon, the freshman from Deltona Taylor High School, gives Daytona State the lead once again in the 25th minute.
Well, I think they've certainly corrected that sloppy play, perhaps from the beginning of the game, and now they've found their legs.
Falcons just have so many weapons offensively. You know it's just a matter of time before they get loose. And now D'Amico, his team with the lead once again, can, again, take a deep breath in goal on the Falcons' side. How about this match so far, Ted? It's been fun to watch, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's exciting. I mean, you don't usually see 5 goals in a soccer game in the first, 26 minutes. Very exciting, but this is not what the fans usually get to see.
This is about as entertaining a match as we've had this year. Daytona State has played in those low-scoring 2-1 style matches. That Eastern Florida one, the first that comes to mind, just a gritty one where you got to grind it out for 90 minutes. It's good to see some teams taking chances, some guys on the fly and really trying to light up the scoreboard, isn't it?
Yeah, they are pouring the gasoline all over the fire right now as far as I'm concerned. This is not, again, what you would normally see, 5 goals in 27 minutes, and so it's full throttle. What we're hoping to see, obviously, in the subsequent minutes is a little bit more of a control game. The defense is to get a little bit more settled.
D'Amico will watch this one into his hands once again. Daytona State Falcons, hard to believe when you watch this program at work, only in their second year of existence. Continuing to set new records, new milestones, and new standards day in and day out. Here's Bailey sending it back. And now the Falcons will let D'Amico touch it once again. Good movement right now from the home team. Thomas University, once again trailing by a goal. You have to wonder, will they be able to equalize? Will they be able to see a lead once again against this hungry Falcons bunch? Here's Segre now playing it in front of the goal as Cranbeck had to come up outside the 6 to reel it in.
I was surprised how Cranbeck was playing so far up, but obviously the right move in that situation.
Nighthawks attacking again. And this is another potential foul, but no whistle this time. Daytona State maybe gets a little lucky. You saw number 14, Kavoy Bailey, chasing.
I thought the other one was not much of a penalty, but this one, I thought, so, you know, maybe we got one back from the referee.
It's not a good angle that time taken by the Nighthawks, so maybe officials gave us the benefit of the doubt. Here's De Leon again playing along the far side, getting a lot of attention right now by the Nighthawks. Service in, and oh, how about that try as Perez tried to tap it on the run. Ball went a little bit high.
Tough. That was, obviously a great pass, a little bit tough of a skip there, but he did a great job just to get it, right within the goal, but just a little bit over.
You know, as fast as this guy is, that's not really what makes his overall game. It's his work ethic. Coach Sasnett says that he's one of the first players to come to the complex, one of the last guys to leave.
And you wish you had 11 of them all the time, don't you?
Nighthawks continuing to attack. Valencia. And now a long shot taken. Easy pickings for D'Amico.
And we had a full complement of defenders back for that.
So the Falcons have gotten their 43rd, 44th, and 45th goals here in this first half. Got a very busy halftime coming up. Definitely want to stay tuned for that, as Daytona State Athletic Director Will Dunn is in the house, going to hand out some very well-deserved honors at halftime. We're going to tell you about our student athletes during the intermission and a whole lot more that's coming up at the half here from Daytona. Marco Tomic. Tomic trying to get as close as he can. Charlton now lost it. Krambeck sends it out.
Just some beautiful dribbling skills showed by Tomic there in a tight squeeze.
So 24, Trevor Golikowski, freshman out of West Palm Beach, a guy that did not have slated to be in the game this early, but getting the golden opportunity to play here against Thomas University. Coach Sasnett said that he hopes to get as many guys into this match as possible. Falcons threatening once again. The nice cross. The shot taken, and a gorgeous goal as Charlton sticks it in to the back of the net to make it 4-2.
Just a gorgeous setup by De Leon. I mean, he was the first guy with it. Passed it off, and I think it was Zagree who got it into
Charlton. The finish. What a surprise he has been this season. He has become a lethal goal scorer, and that was his 7th on the season and just the 24th shot. Just a perfect angle, and how about that view from our goal camera? That's as good as it gets.
Gorgeous replay, and from our goal camera, yes, definitely. Just textbook. Put it away in the bottom right-hand corner. Absolutely textbook.
Falcons looking for another one. Continuing to apply the pressure. Charlton watches this one go, and now Thomas University. Got to be very careful here, Ted, as they were hanging with Daytona State early, but they look like legs are starting to slow down just a bit on the green and white side. They got to be careful here.
Yeah, that's correct. That's a good observation. But I love to see, the Daytona State middies running back full power. That should be a foul.
Falcon went down that time. And now it's Avalaneda who has a goal for the Nighthawks. Getting a lot of attention out there. Thomas University wants a nice long possession here, just something to quiet the noise that the Falcons have been making. What a shot taken. That one sails a little bit to the right, though. That was very close.
Very well done from about 22, 23 yards out. you know, had we had the good defense on him, but he just played a beautiful ball. Just missed the corner of the upper right hand. D'Amico saying, okay, guys, settle down a little bit now, okay.
D'Amico's such a leader for Daytona State. There's Segre sending it downfield. Tell you what, Thomas University, they have got to get more defenders back. They're getting beat down the field. And again, the same setup, trying to create a lane and an angle. And there's a great save by Krambeck.
Incredible skills. Incredible skills, calm, collected, just like before. Great presence in the 18-yard box, Drew.
Brandon Krambeck, you saw the sophomore out of Tallahassee, Florida State University School, located right next to where the Seminoles campus is. Some great athletes have come out of there in the past, and Krambeck, obviously another one. Here's Valencia now. Leading the charge for Thomas University, Nighthawks trying to at least get one goal before intermission. Valencia, here's the shot. D'Amico there to knock it down.
You know, they didn't have numbers there, but they did a great job to get the shot off.
Tell you what, Ted, I'm looking around the field. I'm seeing a lot of guys with their hands on their shorts. There's some tired guys out there. They have been up and down for 40 minutes. This is one of the fastest pace matches I think we've seen in a long time.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they are definitely expending energy here. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a few subs from, you know, both sides in the second half.
That conditioning certainly going to be a huge factor. Craigton Charlton chases it down for Daytona State. Burke sends it up. Burke gets it back. Now Burke, here comes the service. O'Sullivan taken down that time.
Segre almost got to it. Love Segre's distribution skills. Mm-hmm. You know, playing that center mid, you have a lot of responsibility to be the orchestrator, and he's doing just that.
Tomic now to Perez. Now from the right side, it's Bailey. Oh, the header attempted, just couldn't get high enough as Charlton trying to win the ball back, and the official steps in to blow the whistle. Still got to love the effort from Daytona State here with a two-goal lead. Under 10 minutes to play in the first half. Drew Felios with Ted Sofianos. First time we've been together, Ted. So far, so good.
So far, so good. Got two Greeks in the box. I mean, when does that happen? Not too often, I would say.
Probably never.
But truly enjoying it, Drew. Truly enjoying the company up here.
Fans continuing to file in here to Daytona State Soccer Stadium. Just a perfect day for soccer. A little windy at the start, but weather starting to settle down, and the Falcons really starting to soar.
Oh, definitely. And you that was a great example of that triangular grid system that I was mentioning before. The 1-2, boom, boom. You know, they've been taught that since they've been about 5 or 6 years old playing the game.
Arbeláez tied up that time, and it's going to go the way of the Nighthawks. Mateo Arbeláez, freshman mid out of Orlando, Olympia High School represented.
You know, I think Coach would be quite satisfied if they could just stick one more in before they, you know, go with the win, because right now they're against it. But as you mentioned before, it has kind of died down a little bit.
Sub 54.
And a substitution made, that's Joaquin Morlin. Young man is a senior out of Sweden. So interesting you have a senior playing against, of course, all freshmen and sophomores. Whip around shot that time is high. And now we've got less than 8 minutes to play in the first half.
Quite an international presence from TU. Although we do have, you know, some folks on our team, of obviously from Ireland and Jamaica, even from England. But TU has quite a few from abroad. Looks like the pace has just slowed down a little bit, Drew, which I think is just fine as far as the head coach at DSC, Bart Sazenet's concerned.
Daytona State settling this one again, and now Segree working. He'll take a shot. That's a long one. Krambeck will knock it down for the Nighthawks.
He's a little bit disappointed with himself there. He didn't catch all of it, although it did take a couple of, bounces that troubled the keeper, but he was able to corral it in.
Right now, Ted, if you are Daytona State, do you make any adjustments, or do you just continue to do what you have done since the start?
You know, it's interesting you say that. As a coach, I mean, obviously this is a non-conference game. If you're seeing some of your players that might be a little bit winded, you want to save them for the next conference game, which is coming up soon, you might switch them around a little bit. At the same time, you don't want to suffer a loss.
Interesting to see what adjustments, if any, are made at intermission. Depth right now of Daytona State seems to be controlling things as Golikowski sends it to the far side.
Gorgeous fall.
Falcons right now seem like they're in a pretty good rhythm. Here's Charlton. One-on-one, just so good. Perez comes up to give him another chance. Daytona State threatening, trying to get a shot off. Defense able to crowd the box that time. Now it's Bailey. The 1-2 with Sandage. Here's Tomic. A good spot right there. O'Sullivan shaking free, and the empty netter is good.
Incredible. Oh, calling offsides.
That is an offsides. And you saw the reaction from O'Sullivan. The flag did go up. It looked like O'Sullivan may have avoided it that time. He looked back at the official, and unfortunately, that flag was up.
You know, if we see a replay, I'd love to see that again.
Let's take one more look. Falcons methodical. And right there, behind the defense, 56, obviously, trying to draw that offsides. Quadri Glass, and the official right there to blow the whistle.
Great effort, though. Great effort.
So for Daytona State, two goals by O'Sullivan, one by De Leon, and one by Charlton. Coming up on 4 minutes to play in the first half.
Yeah, Drew, you don't see that every day. Three different guys scoring four goals in the first half. Pretty good stats.
Very evenly distributed. Now it's Bailey. Perez and Bailey. Back and forth. Center circle played out by Sandage. Daytona State trying to get a nice long possession here. And waiting just the right time to attack. Charlton now. His skill is just phenomenal. Now the Falcons pull this one back. Straight on shot, taken high. Good idea by Sandage, just a little too far out.
It was just such a gorgeous development from the near side of the field to us, out to the far side, back in. I mean, the wax and wane of that process. You know that Coach Sazenet is very happy with what he just saw.
Tell you what, it's my first time watching Daytona State this season. And a couple of the guys that have really stood out. Obviously, the talent of Charlton, what he does. It is just seamless down on the pitch. And also, Manny Perez, a guy that really stands out as well. Meanwhile, you got the guy doing the dirty work on the inside with O'Sullivan. And I think this team really has the makings to be something special.
Exactly. And Segree as well, the great distributor today.
Tomic. And now Sandage working in the middle of the field. Official now comes to have a conversation as play stops momentarily. Valencia right there in the discussion. Falcons continuing to attack, and we've got a whistle as Charlton goes down.
Yeah, this would be from about 25, 26 yards out. Probably be a direct kick, which means it doesn't have to touch anyone and go right into the net. Indirect obviously has to touch somebody else.
See who does the honors here. So you got Burke there, also O'Sullivan hovering over the ball, Tomic as well. It's Tomic. Ball in play now. Trying to get the cross in a little bit high.
Well-designed play, though. Very well-designed. Service just a little bit too high on the near side.
Skylar Rogers. Make that Leonel Alvarez. Alvarez handling for Thomas University. Young man hailing out of Suwannee. And the city of Live Oak. Left side now. Here's Gray. Gray with the cross. And nobody was home. Good idea. Arbeláez tried to catch up to it.
No, well played by TU, but DSC was running with, they were doing man-to-man right there, and they had it covered.
Alvarez in the center circle. Coming up on 1 minute left to play in the first half. We have had fireworks since the start. A 4-2 match, 6 goals up to this point, and it's only one half of a fabulous doubleheader here at the complex. As we've got the men playing in this match, we've got the ladies coming up a little bit later on today. And Ted, it is really just a great day here to be a Falcon.
Are these fans not entertained? I mean, they've got to be. A lot of action that first half, and I'm excited just to be up here and watching what I'm watching, and certainly as a DSC fan and announcer, it's great to see what Coach Bart has already achieved.
About 15 seconds left to play in regulation. This one cut off. Kolakowski, quality minutes in the first half, and that should do it. So Daytona State trailed for a moment in the first half, a few tense moments here on the pitch, but they came back to score 3 unanswered and right now lead 4-2 as we head to intermission. Coach Bart Sasnett and his team looking for their 9th victory of the season. So told you about the busy halftime festivities coming up as you've got student athletes coming onto the field right now, and especially the athletes that are honored here today. In addition to winning their 9th NJCAA National Championship earlier this year, the Daytona State women's golf team also had the highest GPA in junior college athletics with a 3.79, earning them the overall National Academic Team of the Year award for the 4th year in a row. This is the baseball and women's golf teams that we're watching right now. Baseball team, of course, on the right, women's golf and the light blue on the left. Athletic Director Will Dunn is also on the field doing the honors, and what tremendous years these great athletes have had, Ted.
You know, I have the privilege of knowing the head baseball coach as well as the head golf coach, and I tell you, if you saw our gym with all the pennants involved there for both teams, it's an amazing sight. They have amassed years and years of success, championships, conference championships, and the ladies' golf team, national championship, one after the other.
Again, a 3.79. What a job by the women's golf team. Now, the men's baseball team also going to be honored for their academic achievements during the 2016-17 school year. The team GPA there, 3.7 for the baseball team, awarded the National Academic Men's Team of the Year for the 11th straight year. So women's golf on one side, baseball on the other side. Daytona State student-athletes getting it done in the classroom. 89 student-athletes who earned all-conference academic honors from the Florida College System Activities Association, recognizing student-athletes with a GPA of 3.0 or above. Of those, 48 received academic All-American honors with a 3.6 and above.
Yeah, it's truly amazing. And just some research and statistics that go along with this, it has been proven that students who participate, whether it's in student government or intramurals or even, of course, with college athletics, they are shown to have an 80% more completion and graduation rate.
Yeah, education is so important here at Daytona State College, and our student athletes are dedicated to their educational success. Let's take a look.
I think that our first priority as student athletes is obviously our class. So when we go into class, we obviously, that's our first priority. And so when we go into class, we work hard in class. That just shows in the field as players. So when we come out to practice, we know that we've worked hard in the classroom, and now we have to work hard on the field.
Doing well in the classroom has helped me on the field, because if you can get your classwork done, then you're really not worried about anything else. You can worry about soccer. And it's really nice to have a clear head for soccer.
So I think that the classroom is directly related to being on the field. I believe that if you try hard in every aspect of your life, then it'll translate over to other things. So if we do well in the classroom and put in the hard work there, then you'll definitely put the hard work in for your teammates.
Your performance in the classroom definitely does affect your performance on the field, because if you was to do bad in the classroom, you know, that's always playing your mind, and you know, you may not be able to perform as good when you come onto the field, so definitely it's like the same.
I'm doing really good in the classroom so far. I think doing good in the classroom really comes and shows on the field, because if you're doing good in the classroom, then it just brings a lot more to the field.
Academic success is one of our core values, so that holds us responsible, and responsibility on the field is a really big trait to have, and creates trustworthiness with the teammates, and it's easier to play.
We hold our student athletes to the highest standards, so we expect our athletes to put the same intensity and effort into their academic performance as they do into their athletic performance. So their performance in the classroom is a direct reflection of the dedication, discipline, and their adherence to our core values as their athletic performance. So for our team, you know, our athletes are expected to adhere to certain core values, and those apply to that classroom and the field, and all those discipline, dedication, commitment, and all of those things are reflected in the same environment academically.
Daytona State College of Education is forever grateful to Volusia and Flagler County Schools and our collaborative partnership that allows us to spend this exciting time out in the field working with these wonderful students, doing one-on-one reading instruction 4 days a week.
Daytona State has definitely prepared me for being a teacher with all the fieldwork that we've been able to experience through the program, as well as the support and help from all of our wonderful professors. And being able to work one-on-one with the students has been a wonderful opportunity to experience that already before I get placed in my senior internship.
Halftime here at Daytona State's gorgeous soccer stadium. Drew Felios alongside Ted Sofianis and our fabulous crew here at Daytona State College. 4-2, the lead for the Falcons over the Nighthawks. And if you like goals, you'd love the first half because we saw six of them total.
Oh, yeah. I'm just glad I didn't scream out, you know, into my a cappella yelling goal. But I would have done it too many times where my voice would have been lost by now.
Shots were coming from all over the place. And how about Mr. Joe O'Sullivan twice early on, able to stick it back in on rebounds. But the Nighthawks want some offense of their own. Samuel Valencia with the penalty kick, able to cash one in. And then Thomas University continuing to play fast, getting one behind the defense here. And this is Gonzalez Avellaneda, the freshman out of Spain, making it a 2-1 game. Daytona State trying to slow things down, trying to gather their senses, a little bit shocked here at home. Krambeck, the keeper for the Nighthawks, with a good save there. Continuing to be under fire, O'Sullivan cashes in again.
Again, I mean, that one should have been corralled by the keep. But again, you got to be at the right place, right time, and O'Sullivan was there. Great job.
De Leon also had one of those goals right in front of the net.
Yeah, obviously, I'm making it sound easier than this. It was a good shot, but goalie didn't let it stick to the hands.
Joey Lopez filling in as the coach today for Thomas University. And the shots kept on coming. The Falcons easily outshooting Thomas University. Here's De Leon. This was a fabulous play.
Incredible. I mean, you're really looking at right there some even semi, those are maybe semi-pro to pro level skills. Calmness in the box, just incredible.
How about the flick try by Perez that time, and that was the goal by Charlton. Our goalie camera picking that one up, and how about the skill of 29?
Amazing. I mean, I'm so impressed with all these guys, but.
Yeah, it really has been a special afternoon of soccer so far. Well, we are broadcasting from the brand new Daytona State Soccer Stadium, and this venue setting the standard for soccer complexes nationwide at this level. Let's take a closer look at how this great complex came together.
DSC Soccer Complex will be an outstanding sports venue that will attract a loyal Falcon fan base in the community we have here today. Equally significant, it will become a learning laboratory for students in our upcoming sports broadcasting TV program.
It's fantastic. The new facility is fantastic. We can't complain. The surface is grass. It's wonderful. It's a big field. We have great support. Dr. Labasso got his jumbo screen behind us, and that's a great experience for the fans, and obviously the girls like it. So, you know, it's a very, very nice place to train every day. It's a great place to hold games, and we're very grateful for the opportunity to be in it.
It feels amazing. I mean, the stands, everything looks great. You know, it's just a plus. I mean, we're a good team, so that just brings us, you know, more energy to play and win.
Being a brand new program is really exciting, and the fact that we're competing so well against these teams that have been together for a long time feels really good. And having a new stadium as a new program is really rewarding, especially since our season last year was so good.
It feels great coming here. I mean, I was here last year, and the new stadium was something we always looked forward to last year. We were just like, oh, I can't wait to play in our new stadium on campus. And the best part is that we have the TV program, so it helps expose our team. We got a really good team, so I'm just excited every time we get to step out here.
You gotta find a way to put the ball in the back of the net more consistently when you get those chances. Because when you're playing a good team, you're not gonna get that many chances. So you gotta maximize your opportunities.
Welcome back to Daytona State Soccer Stadium here in gorgeous Daytona Beach. Drew Felios alongside Ted Sofianos, 4-2, your score at intermission as we get set to begin the second half. And you saw some of the footage from homecoming, a very special time here in Falcon Nation. This is the 60th anniversary of Daytona State College. Of course, the great college began in 1957 as Daytona Beach Junior College. Now it is completely evolved and entering a new era. Only the second year of soccer, all the great opportunities it has offered young people. And with this stadium and with everything we have going on, Ted, you cannot help but just be elated.
Oh, it's amazing. Obviously, our main campus is where we are, you know, watching play. But, you know, five other satellite campuses, a bevy of 2 to 4 year programs. What do you call them? 2+2 within. Certainly, we can highlight our new we have a new brewing AS degree, which is really interesting for those who are into the hops and the spirits. But certainly right here, that has to do with this stadium, is the television broadcasting Associate of Science degree broadcast television production. It's a degree program which provides students with hands-on experience through DSC's public TV station.
Phil D'Amico conceded a couple goals in the first half, but eventually settled in, and his team able to equalize and build a 2-goal advantage as Daytona State looking for their 9th victory of the season. Right now ranked number 8 in the NJCAA. I think put on their toes on notice a little bit about 10 minutes in to that first half. But, Ted, I really like the way that they were able to respond. They did not panic.
Yeah, they suffered a small scare there, right? I think coach got into their ear a bit and certainly calmed them down and said, gentlemen, need to regroup and start. And this is what you're seeing right now, how they're playing from side to side, weak side to strong side. It's been some really nice developing plays that we've watched over the, and perhaps that's why we've seen a number of goals. Just some great development out there.
Should see several substitutes here in the second half of play. We'll keep you posted on those. Tomic gets it ahead. Falcons threatening, and offside going to be called there on that first possession.
Sneaky call by the referee there. I didn't see the flag go up right away, but he probably was off. You can't really tell from this vantage point.
How about the progress that this program has made from year one to year two? Last season finishing 7th in the nation at 17-3-1, ranked as high though as number 2 a season ago.
Yeah, can you imagine your first year, you're traveling out west for the NJCAA title? I mean, that's pretty incredible for an inaugural year. I mean, that pretty much sets the stage for things to come.
If you're just joining us, it was an explosive first half of action. The wind has really come down here at the complex. We'll see if that affects play in the second 45. Weather was ugly throughout Central Florida today, but it sort of dodged Daytona Beach here whenever it really mattered. So we have been unfazed up to this point, and hopefully that continues with the women's contest coming up a little bit later today.
Certainly fortunate. We hope it holds together for the ladies. The Lady Falcons.
Daytona State will take on Broward College. That game coming up with about a 6 o'clock start time. Should be a few minutes past that. Of course, after the conclusion of this one, and the teams get a chance to warm up on the field.
Yeah, and certainly an important game for the Lady Falcons because it'll be a conference game. You know, that right there was an example of players needed to show themselves. When I say show themselves, they need to come back to the defenses, owning the ball at that point in time, and they have to make runs back. And, you know, maybe you're sitting on a 4-2 lead, but at the same time, that's if I was a coach, that's what I would want to see.
Falcons now playing it in the center circle, but unable to control it. Donovan Segui gets it ahead now. He's very active in the first 45.
You know, I didn't get an update on any substitutes for DSC, did we, Drew?
Did not. Saw one yellow card dished out in the first half, so that makes it 9 now on the season. And the one red card for D'Amico, one that made the goalie have to sit out last time out for Daytona State. But Charlie Roberts did a great job off the bench in the last contest, a clean sheet to his credit. So it's good to see that the Falcons do have some depth at that spot if needed.
Correct. It's nice when you can rely on some of your backups. I mean, that's their job, of course, come off the bench. Oh, here's a play developing almost.
Brandon Kelly tosses it in for the Nighthawks. Sam Ives and Segree now on the ball for Daytona State.
Yeah, displaying some nice possession skills there, and then back to his primary job distribution.
If you are Daytona State right now, Ted, do you try and maybe play a little bit more conservatively and sit on the lead, or do you continue to attack and add as many goals as possible?
I'd say it's somewhere in between for Coach Sazdin, because certainly you don't want to play up as if you were losing the game, you know, and throw all your guys forward. In this particular case, you're going to do something in between, but you know, with a 4-2 lead and you know with wind in your favor, I think the DSC Falcons will. We'll look to play it strategically and somewhere in the middle, kind of a wax and wane where you just said. Somewhere right in the middle, I believe. That would be the best tempo, I think. Because you remember it was gangbusters those first 25, 30 minutes. And it looks just play has slowed down just a bit. And that might be by design. We'll have to see how the gentlemen fare.
Donovan Segree, first-team All-Conference last year. Tremendous on the attack. Sophomore in that midfield spot for Daytona State. De Leon comes up to play it. Brandon Kelly, solid for Thomas University. Now it's Arbelias. Avalaneda got a nice touch. And now Sandage. Sandage has been kind of a thorn in the side of Thomas here today in that midfield.
Bit of a late call by the ref there, but they'll take the offsides for TU.
So just to recap, two straight goals by Joe O'Sullivan. Then Miguel De Leon. Craigton Charlton, also a goal for Daytona State. Golikowski sent it out that time for the home team, so Thomas University will have a throw-in.
Yeah, foul called there. Not too dangerous of a position in the field. Certainly something to be wary about. They're going to mark up pretty tight.
So this is going to be Jose Carlos Gonzalez Avalaneda. By far the longest name on the field here today for Thomas University. This guy already has a goal.
DSC has built a three-man wall, and the ball's about 33 yards out.
There's a nice strike, but just to the left.
D'Amico using that wind to his advantage for the outlet pass.
Charlton now decides to attack, just trying to outrun the defense on his own. Two defenders get back. Here comes the cross, and that was almost in there. If it had gotten by that last defender, it would have been a goal.
Yeah, he had him on the far side. He was calling for it. Saw it, but just didn't get there. Nice control here by DSC.
Dylan Burke, service in. Tomic. Now faces just outside that 18. Sending it back. Sandage. And now Segree. Boy, Segree shows such great composure. Now De Leon can't control it, and it rolls out. It'll be a goal kick.
Yeah, just push that a little bit too far. DeLeon will learn from that. That was a small mistake.
So I believe we got a new goalie on the Thomas University side here in half number two. And that is definitely a new keeper as number 30 gets in. That's Gabe Garcia, the redshirt sophomore out of Tampa, and Brooks DeBartolo, collegiate. Of course, you know who that high school is named after, the great Derrick Brooks, the football player, Hall of Famer.
Correct.
Linebacker for the Bucks, and the great Eddie DeBartolo, another football Hall of Famer, former owner of the San Francisco 49ers.
Oh, excellent. I'm not going to play you in Sports Jeopardy.
A couple dynasties there. As you get a look at Garcia.
Yeah, I'm not sure if the other keeper, they took him out because of the four goals, or they just wanted to give Garcia a look. Because chances are Garcia is gonna see some shots taken.
Oh, without question. Good job that time by O'Sullivan. Boy, O'Sullivan just continues to be a workhorse.
He's a grinder, isn't he?
Just does not stop running. Now DeLeon, able to control it.
Beautiful development up the center.
Daytona State right now establishing a nice flow. Here's Segre squirting a pass through. Charlton one-on-one, and he is going to score. Oh, no, the offside's called. Once again, I'll tell you what, I thought he had shaken free that time.
I don't know who's calling offsides, but it wasn't on Charlton. The Zebra, I think, got it wrong there. You know, I call them Zebras because I'm old school. I mean, they don't wear the black and whites anymore. They're wearing these different kind of nouveau shirts, these guys these days. But I would have taken umbrage with that one.
Tony Bommert, our official down there with Nardi Abeshi.
It looks like a call's going our way there.
I think the officials have called a pretty solid match. We've had a couple questionable offsides, but I think overall they've let the players play. I think it's been a physical match at times, but how would you assess the way that they have called this match?
I think it's pretty fair. You know, every once in a while you're going to try to pick apart what a linesman or a head referee does, but at the same time, you see D'Amico's leg on with this wind. It's impressive. I mean, he's distributing the ball on the left wing now several times that I've watched and used the wind to his advantage.
Right back the other way. Nighthawks trying to make the Falcons pay, and the Falcons had to retreat that time. Tomic able to come away with it. Thomas University threatening once again. Here's Arbeláez taking the shot, but again, the defense there to help.
Well done, well done. When in doubt, kick it out.
Ted, that's the one thing about Daytona State. Even when they are beaten defensively, they've got the skill, they've got the will and the speed to get back and deny the goal.
And just the wherewithal of that defender, I think it was Segre that just played that out. Nice and calm, collected, even though, as you noticed, TU had numbers there. It was a 4v3.
Top of the 18 now. Falcons able to crowd that box and regain possession.
Great skills by Segre there.
Now it's DeLeon in the midfield. Tomic. Here's Sandage. Sandage keeps it for just a moment. How about that move? Passing it to himself. Sandage along the right side. Great composure. That one is sent out, and it'll be a throw-in. Nearly a corner kick that time.
It was a gorgeous development from the near side to the far side. Possession it the whole time.
Here's Tomic. Straight on now, approaching the 18. Sandage.
DSC really pressing now.
Sent in with the left foot and denied by Brandon Kelly. Top of the 18. Straight on shot, deflected. One more try for the Falcons. And this one sails just a little bit high. Had tons of velocity. That ball was screaming.
Oh, that was struck well. I'm not sure what the flag was for. Interesting call is the only adjective I could put on that by the ref there.
How about Donovan Segre, though? Sophomore midfielder. Another youngster out of Jamaica. I'll tell you what, the country of Jamaica has been very kind to this program over the past few years, and I think Coach Bart Sassnett has established what hopefully is a pipeline in years to come, Ted.
He obviously has some great connections. I mean, he's been in the business for a number of years now, and, you know, been coaching since 2001.
D'Amico in position to knock that one down. Good effort that time by Samuel Valencia. Sandage gets it through. O'Sullivan now operates for Daytona State. Now it's De Leon. You got to wonder how long can Thomas University continue to run with the Falcons playing at full speed.
They're going to have to get on sides here.
Good interior passing by Daytona State. Now it's Burke. De Leon runs over to the corner to play it. See if they can serve this one in. Tomic trying to do just that, but the defense marking the Falcons tightly that time.
Nice possession game, though, they're playing right now. From both sides of the field, from the near side and the weak side, doing a heck of a job. Ref caught him again. I know he tried his best to stay on sides. It was just a little bit too quick with that move.
So the Falcons racking up the offsides penalties here in the second half.
Great to be aggressive, but at the same time, you have to rely on your timing. You have to see where you have to be, you know, have the eyes in the back of your head, see where that other defender is in order to know when to release and sprint.
Here's Fall. Avalaneda has been the best threat today for Thomas University. He's got it right now. Already with one goal, Falcons able to team up on him and take it away that time. Now it's Felix. Played out of the center circle. This is Arbeláez. Once again, belonging to the Nighthawks. You know what? I really like Thomas University's game plan, Ted, here in the second half. They've been able to sort of control the ball, frustrating the offense a little bit from Daytona State. They just haven't been able to get a real good, true shot on goal.
And their fullbacks or their defensive line has been very disciplined. And that's how come some of the offsides calls have come about.
See how long they can sustain it. Here, we're about 18 minutes in to the second half of play. Kolakowski trying to send it back, and we're going to have a goal kick coming up here at Daytona State Soccer Stadium in Daytona Beach. Hope you're enjoying it. The Falcons hosting Thomas University's JV squad. And we've seen a flurry of goals in the first 45. Have not seen a goal yet in the second half.
Oh, it's a little bit of the opposite, isn't it? I think the defenses have finally kind of tamped things down a little bit for both sides. And that might be by design from both coaches.
Exciting time for soccer, not just here, but collegiately and all over the world. How about the United States with a big match coming up against Panama? World Cup qualifier.
And who knows, we might be hosting some of those qualifiers right here in this beautiful new stadium.
There you go. So much to look forward to. And the months ahead. Oh, there's a collision down near the box and pulling it out again is Phil D'Amico. D'Amico has done a good job in goal since that early flurry in the first half that saw the Nighthawks put up two.
And just to kind of take off of what we just said, in November 3rd through the 5th, we will be holding the Region 8 conference tourney here at this stadium.
Definitely dates to keep an eye on. Now it's De Leon along the left side. Miguel De Leon, and should have a corner kick coming up.
He's called it a goal kick.
No, it will be a goal kick. Yeah. Went off De Leon at the last moment. And Miguel runs back a little bit gingerly. He's got one goal here today, six on the season.
You can just see that ball from the goal kick just flailing in the wind as it's against
Arbeláez. Good pass in there. Now Felix trying to do something with it, but again, the back line in position. There's a shot straight on and knocked down again by D'Amico.
That was a whistler. Well corralled by the goalie, by D'Amico. Yeah, things have certainly settled down comparatively to the first half.
Arbeláez holds it up for Thomas University. They have not looked like a team with one win here today. Especially here in the second half, dictating the tempo. Daytona State unable to add to their lead. At the moment, at least. Well, Daytona State will have a special ribbon cutting for this new soccer stadium. That is October 10th at 5:30 p.m. Of course, that'll be during the Eastern Florida State College big match coming up on the 10th. So the ribbon cutting going to happen here. That's going to be obviously a very exciting night, an emotional night as well for everybody involved in constructing this fabulous venue here on campus.
Oh, yeah.
And we are broadcasting that night as well. So Eastern Florida going to come in here. That's such a fun rivalry. And Daytona State on the men's and women's side has gotten the better end of it so far this fall. Here's Noah Graziano, who just entered the game for the Falcons, getting his first touch. Donovan Segre.
Just a gorgeous pass there.
So a chance for some of the reserves to maybe get into the scoring column and just contribute. Good pass there. Falcons trying to play it again. Burke with a touch. Now the Falcons trying to have a nice long possession. De Leon with it. De Leon, very calculating, snuck a pass in. Shot taken, deflected off the feet. Now Graziano trying to make something happen on his own. Falcons with another shot and a goal. How about that? It was De Leon who got the pass through traffic, and he knew what to do with it. It's 5-2.
You know, beautiful patience shown there. They just kept pushing the line of defenders back all the way to the six-yard box, and like you said, just a great through pass, and keeper had no chance on that one.
Well, you saw Gabe Garcia, the redshirt sophomore, maybe a little inexperienced there coming into play as he comes out, and it just left the goal wide open for De Leon to cash in on the easy goal.
What I'm really impressed with what the gents are showing is that east-west, you know, back and forth of the field, which is always going to catch players on the weak side off guard. It's a great tactic. They've obviously shown strength with it, and I think they'll continue.
So call it a goal in the 68th minute for Miguel De Leon. And that's his second on the afternoon. So O'Sullivan and De Leon both with two goals. A little holding going on there. Segree had the back of his jersey tugged, and we play on. Graziano trying to get a pass in. Flag does not go up. We play on. And how about that save made by Garcia?
Good save by the keep and a good exchange. And again, I think it was Segree who set that up to begin with.
Have a corner kick. A three-goal lead for the Falcons. Marco Tomic. Nice and high. And it drops right in for the Nighthawks to clear it. Well, no matter what happens from here on out, this has certainly been a much more competitive match than the last time these two clubs faced off. That was a 10-3 win for Daytona State. Thomas University's had a much better showing here today. Arbeláez now operating as they continue to work hard. Avellaneda, the shot. And this one will sail just high. That shot actually taken by number 8, Victor Felix, the freshman out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Yeah, obviously, I think a more respectable showing than the 10-3, but certainly 5-2, you know, if I was to you, try to get one more goal, 5-3, a little bit more respectable, of course. But DC showing admirable skills, good fundamentals, both in the box and outside. And much more disciplined, I believe, than they were in the first 20 minutes of the first half.
Daytona State with some nice wins to their credit this fall. Flagler College won. Embry-Riddle also. Kaiser University another. Eastern Florida, that big win back on September 20th. And ASA out of Miami, that was a 3-2, two overtime win on the first of this month. So just a few days ago, Daytona State tested. And I think it's critical that, you know, you have those tight wins. You've also got maybe a blemish or two on your schedule. It's good to have a team that's seen a little bit of everything heading into the postseason, because you're going to see so many different types of situations, aren't you?
Yeah, and that way it doesn't keep you overconfident.
Sure.
Like we were saying in the beginning of this game, you know, the DSC, you know, Falcons were, I think at first, maybe a little bit overconfident based on the last time these two teams met. But then they started to get their game together, and I'm sure Coach had a lot to do with that.
A little over 18 minutes to play here in regulation. Ball will belong to Daytona State once again.
And so the simple things like that, like running down that ball as hard as he did, ensuring that the ball would be a throw-in for his teammates.
Now it's Segree. Switching it to the near side. Dylan Burke. Chance to control for the Falcons. Anthony Smith now with it. Smith holding things up. So Anthony Smith getting a chance to contribute. The freshman out of Palm Coast and Flagler Palm Coast High School. Now it's Segree. Segree puts a little air under this one. And now the Nighthawks able to get it back.
Yeah, I reside in Palm Coast, and I've gotten to see a few of the high school games. And Smith, certainly an outstanding player. Good addition to this team here.
Colicchio trying to keep pace on that far side. And now Nighthawks trying to service one in, but D'Amico easily there to pick it up. as we are nearing the stretch run here at Daytona State Soccer Stadium. About 80 degrees today on a very windy day. So winds have calmed down, and both teams have really settled in here. Only one goal, though, in the second half. That belongs to Miguel De Leon, who scored a beauty just minutes ago.
Which the pace of play, as far as goal scoring goes, that's much more normal.
Sure. Falcons once again try and get it in position. This ball sent in. Garcia able to pick it up off the turf.
Just looked like a little bit of a misread there.
I talked about all the adversity that Daytona State has faced this year, Ted. We haven't even mentioned Hurricane Irma and the four games that were either canceled or postponed. Here, of course, the women's program and so many programs affected throughout the state of Florida. The weather has just really wreaked havoc on the soccer season this year, hasn't it?
Yes, and I still know some families who are, even some of our soccer families. You just mentioned Smith, who's a resident of Palm Coast, hit really bad, and there's actually still flooding today based on what's going on out there with the winds.
Galicio tried to send that one in. Here's a long shot taken. Garcia there to get a glove on it, and a good save again by Garcia. And I got to mention that, this upcoming Thursday, October 5th, the Daytona State College volleyball team will be gathering donations for Puerto Rico at their home match versus Lake Sumter at 7 o'clock. And a couple members of our athletic program, two Puerto Rican natives, Urelis Rios out of the volleyball team, and Tina Velasquez out of the softball team. Of course, our hearts and thoughts and prayers with their families, obviously affected. For a list of requested donation items, please visit dscfalcons.com. That is tomorrow night, DSC volleyball gathering to honor some of the victims and Puerto Rico, and obviously area still dealing very much with the effects of the storm. Hurricane Maria as well.
Great skills in the center there.
Garcia has been a busy guy here in the second half. Gabe Garcia conceding one goal, but trying to take charge out there right now.
Yeah, he's been tested a few times, and all but once, I mean, he's shown up for the task.
Of course, after this match today, Daytona State will welcome Broward College. That on Friday night, 6 p.m. start time for that match. And then head to Weber International. And then on Tuesday, we're back here as Eastern Florida comes to town. Ted, you'll be back here for that one with me. Really looking forward to that one.
Oh, very much so. Certainly, that's only 2 years and they're already our rival.
Going to continue to heat up as well. Kavoy Bailey.
Yeah, it's interesting you mentioned that, Drew, because we have four conference games coming up within the next 2.5-3 weeks.
Next couple weeks of the season, going to be absolutely huge. Graziano, nice touch that time. And Daytona State just trying to play keep away here from the Nighthawks and wrap this one up. Anthony Smith, the second, sends it back to Sandage, his teammate.
Yeah, good clear there by TU.
Credit the Nighthawks. They have kept on playing. 25, Jose Carlos Gonzalez Avalaneda has been so impressive today. He's got it right now. Notice he's wearing 21 on the jersey, 25 on the shorts. We're going by the shorts here today.
Good attention to detail, Drew. I did miss that.
country of Spain has produced some fabulous players that come to the United States to enhance their training. He is obviously another. Here he is, Avellaneda. Tried the 1-2 that time, but did not get it back as Alvarez had it taken from him. Coming up on the 80th minute here in Daytona, Falcons continuing to attack. Graziano had it, then sent it back. Graziano comes back to it. Little hesitation.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh, nice cross that time. That was a great idea.
Great job just developing the play and doing it with several players hanging back. If you've noticed, they've kind of the design here is, you know, and I don't want to say they're guarding the lead, but certainly you don't have to press as much.
Great recognition by Graziano. The pass and the shot was by Carlos Calicchio, the freshman out of Orlando's Montverde Academy. You talk about a soccer program, Montverde. I've had a chance to work a couple of their games at Walt Disney World, the ESPN Wide World of Sports. I'll tell you what, Ted, this team can bring it, Montverde Academy.
Oh, excellent. What age group are we talking about?
Oh, we're talking about high school kids and a program that is sending one athlete after the other to the college level. Daytona State is going to continue to recruit athletes from Montverde Academy. They are really something special. Not just in soccer either, basketball as well.
Well, that's a program where obviously we're going to be looking for in the future to hopefully get a few more picks since they're developing those kind of players out there.
Yeah, recruiting. Coach Bart Sasnett doing such a fabulous job, as you said earlier, Ted, with his connections and evaluating the talent all over the country, figuring out the best fits for this program. Samuel Valencia continuing to be active for Thomas University, trying to get in position. I'll tell you what, 37 in white, he has worked so hard here today. You almost want to see him get a goal, even though he plays for
right,
the opposition.
Right, exactly. He's dangerous. Dangerous player. He's showing his skill level there, and all we could do was settle for a corner. And obviously in a tight game, I mean, corners are a coveted part. Right now, though, like you said, I mean, they would love to gain at least a goal on us with 8 minutes and 42 seconds remaining.
So Valencia, the senior out of Miramar, puts it in play. Now Avellaneda, the shot. He has got a lethal foot, and that goes off the crossbar.
That was quite a strike. That was from about 30 yards out, hit the crossbar. Excellent shot, excellent skill shown there. We're lucky to get away with them not scoring at that point.
That was Avellaneda again. So Avellaneda and Valencia, 25 and 37. Exceptional days today for Thomas University. Now it's Micah Gray. Gray operating. The ball rolls out of bounds.
Good slide tackle there.
Take one more look. This is that shot and the vantage point of D'Amico. Can you imagine having this thing whistle at you from this far out? Look out.
Man, had some steam on it, didn't it? Great camera positioning. Good job, cameras.
Soccer is certainly a game of inches, isn't it?
It certainly is. That needed to be about 6 or 8 below the crossbar.
Graziano sent it downfield, and now the ball kicked out of bounds. And outside the complex, it'll be a throw-in for Daytona State. Final 7 minutes. Falcons trailed for a brief period of time in the first half after taking a 1-0 lead. But would eventually erase that goal. As Joe Sullivan was able to equalize, and then three goals, two by De Leon, one by Charlton, to give them the three-goal lead.
Now, to their credit and their maturity as a team, especially not being together all so long, they didn't panic. They didn't panic. They were a goal down, and obviously they showed their persistence and, like you said before, resiliency to come on back and put it together.
Now Falcons trying to let everybody touch it here in the final minutes. Here's Anthony Smith the second. Hands it off to his teammate, Dylan Burke. Burke, service in, has a guy there. And the ball deflected that time near a handball by Colicchio.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that go off of one of their players or off one of ours. If it was one of ours, it might have been better just left alone on that one. Well, as things wind down, I'm really glad to see that Coach Sasnett has gotten in some subs, some playing time with a 5-2 lead, trying to build on that, obviously.
Now Dylan Burke again, working out of center circle. Davidson Mira, the freshman forward out of Tampa, has entered the game for Daytona State. So a good opportunity for several youngsters to get in here as you get a look at Coach Bart Sasnett. Team cruising right now to their ninth win of the season. Talked about the adversity that his team has faced. He also says that this team, the sophomores that are on the roster right now, have improved tremendously from the time that they were freshmen. You know, remember, at this level, you only get players for 2 years. They have got to make that great jump, Ted, from that first to their second year.
Exactly. And he obviously has the recipe to do that. I mean, he runs a tight camp, a disciplined gentleman. You know, Bart Sasnett is a head coach, but also very much overlooks, doesn't, I don't mean it that way when you say overlook, but he makes sure that the grades are on point with these students.
Falcons get another good pass there, but the final third cut off. And now under 4 minutes to play here at Daytona State Soccer Stadium. 5-2 your score, Drew Felios, Ted Sofianos. Keep in mind at the conclusion of this contest, going to have about a 15 to 20 minute intermission, and then the women will take the field as Broward College will battle your Falcons. Cannot wait for that one coming up a little bit after 6 o'clock.
Yes, and we'll be working double duty for that, Drew. And I'm excited, you know, it's going to be a great game to watch, and wishing our Lady Falcons well.
Nighthawks continuing to try and manufacture a shot. Both teams able to establish a pretty nice flow here in the second half. And I think Phil D'Amico in the net has held up his end of the bargain here today. He has had another solid outing after Thomas University peppered him with shots in the first 15 minutes.
That was a lively half for sure.
Ball now loose. Nighthawks have a chance trying to squirt free, and the shot is taken. It's just high. That was Valencia who had his best shot of the day. The senior out of Miramar cannot believe he missed that one.
Yeah, and D'Amico is giving it to one of his players for not hustling back on that one because it was a fortuitous deflection for TU, but you know you have to anticipate.
So under 2 minutes now and a three-goal lead. Got to ask you, Ted, last year, Daytona State going to the national tournament, won the Southeast, won the state of Florida, eventually fell to Monroe College out of Tyler, Texas in the second round. Do you think that the program can take another step this season?
You know, these last four I think they can, of course. I mean, of course, I'm going to be positive about it. I'm seeing skill levels out here and production levels out here that I think have ascended since last year. But at the same time, they've got a lot, you know, crammed into these last 2.5 weeks for conference games. So they're going to have to be on their toes. Certainly, I think they can do it. And I'd like to see, of course, as the coach and the president of the college would, even a better showing. But that's still great for the first year. Great accomplishment, great achievement for the first year. And not only the coach, but the players themselves. I mean, they should be darn proud of themselves. You know, I don't know the stats on this one, but how many go to the, you know, NJCAA, you know, national tournament, mm-hmm. you know, for their inaugural year?
It's certainly something you got to earn. Daytona State in the process of that right now. And about to move to 9-1. Coliccio trying to squirt free. Look at the effort all the way down to the wire, even pleading for a foul. Not going to get it, but still got to love the effort that he is showing. Final 10 seconds.
At the end of the game, we're going to do a wrap.
So that will do it. 5-2 final score. Daytona State, the Falcons, get the win over Thomas University's men's JV team. 5-2 is the final. Daytona State trailed for a bit, came back, took care of business. Ted, what are the big things do you think that the Falcons can take from this match?
There's a number of things, but I mean the few fundamentals that I'll go over with you quickly. Possession, one. They show and the most interesting part of that, they did it from both sides of the field. They were able to seamlessly take the ball from the weak side to the far side and do it in such a way that they would consistently have guys open on the far side or the near side as they kept going back and forth, and that's two. And three, certainly some of our standouts, as you had mentioned before, O'Sullivan, I keep pronouncing his name wrong, but Segre, certainly Perez, and Charlton. And of course, we can't go without saying D'Amico.
Joe O'Sullivan, two goals. Miguel De Leon, two goals as well. Charlton pitched in one of his own. So 5-2, the final count as Daytona State victorious. And remember, on Friday, they'll welcome Broward College, then head to Weber International on Sunday and come back here for a special ribbon-cutting match against Eastern Florida next Tuesday. Ted, it's been fun. We still got one big game to go here tonight as the women are on deck.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that one. This is going to be a conference game, so very excited to see how that might turn out. And glad to work with you again, Drew, in just a few minutes.
So final score, 5-2. Want to thank all the hardworking individuals on our crew doing a great job tonight on the field and in the control room as well. For Ted Sofianos and our great crew, I'm Drew Felios. Daytona State victorious. A big day for Craigton Charlton and company as they go on to win 5-2. Until next time, saying so long from Daytona Beach. The women are on deck.